Hello friends. I know that many of you are interested in the topic of using the universal protocol matter in smart home systems, whose main task is to ensure device compatibility across different ecosystems, Apple HomeKit, Google Home, Amazon Alexa, and of course, Home Assistant. Recently, I made a video showing the connection of Matter devices over Wi-Fi. If you missed it, the link is in the description. This review is essentially a continuation, but with the difference that we will be discussing Matter devices over Thread. Let me remind you that Thread is an energy-efficient mesh network, somewhat like an advanced version of Zigbee with IP address support. Alongside Wi-Fi, Thread is one of the main transport networks for Matter. Just to clarify, Matter is a logical data transfer protocol, while Wi-Fi and Thread are physical networks. For organizing a Wi-Fi network, a regular home router is used, whereas for Thread, as well as for Zigbee, an additional central hub is needed. In a Zigbee network, this is called a coordinator, and in Thread, it is known as a border router. Before we begin, as usual, I ask you to like this video so more people interested in the smart home topic can find it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Recently, my first devices supporting Matter over Thread arrived, allowing me to practically study this topic. I decided to make three separate small reviews. In this one, I will show the preparation process, creating a border router, installing, and configuring the necessary add-ons in Home Assistant. In the following ones, there will be reviews and connections for each of the devices. I think this way it will be easier to find the necessary information. For these experiments, I received a couple of wonderful network coordinators, SMLight SLZB06, special thanks to their manufacturer. I have been using the same coordinator in my working Zigbee network for a long time and am very satisfied with it. I also want to note that recently Home Assistant has gained the ability to work with Thread border router not only directly connected via USB, but also over the network, which became possible thanks to a request from the creators of SMLight devices. This is exactly how I intend to conduct my testing. Let's start by creating the border router, the central hub of our future Thread network. Its task is to assign addresses to all connected devices and interact with the external system, in this case, Home Assistant. As I mentioned, I will be using the SMLight SLZB06. The first step is to update its firmware. The current version at the time of testing is 2.2.8 dev, which supports Matter over Thread mode and data exchange with the radio module at a speed of 460,800 bits/section. I must highlight the convenience of all firmware updates, switches, and settings. Everything is done through the web interface and does not require special knowledge, tools, or software. Next, we need to go to the mode section. By default, Zigbee coordinator is set here, but we need Matter over Thread. This requires installing special firmware for the radio module, but as I said, everything is done in a few clicks directly from the web interface. This is the last warning before reflashing the radio module. Just to clarify, you can switch back to Zigbee coordinator or router mode at any time directly in the interface. Wait a few minutes while the special firmware version for the radio module is downloaded and installed. Done, it is now a Thread border router instead of a Zigbee coordinator. There is one more step left. For network devices of this class, I mean Zigbee coordinator, Bluetooth proxy, border router, it is important to have a fixed IP address in the home network. You can set this on your router or in the interface by going to the network settings section, disabling DHCP mode, and manually specifying a free address. With the hardware part done, the Thread border router is ready to work. Now it's time to move on to the software part. To get everything working, we will need two add-ons available in the standard Home Assistant repository, Matter Server and Open Thread Border Router. I've previously discussed Matter Server in another video, link in the description, but there's nothing to configure here, just install and launch it, ensuring that the auto start and watchdog options are enabled. The current version at the time of testing is 6.0.0, which supports Matter version 1.3. In the Open Thread Border Router add-on, some configurations need to be made before launching, so open the Configuration tab. This is what it looks like by default. First, there is a list of serial ports. If you have a USB stick connected, it will be visible here. Thread firmware is available for them too, for example, for SunOff E or SkyConnect based on EFR32MG21. Then there are the data exchange speed and hardware flow control. Next is the automatic firmware installation option, which is relevant for the mentioned SkyConnect, logging level, firewall for unnecessary traffic, an AT64, and two switches for displaying in used options and network ports. What needs to be set? Specify any unused serial port. Otherwise, the add-on will not be able to save the configuration. Leave the speed at 460800. Disable both hardware flow control and automatic firmware installation as we do not need them. Do not touch the firewall and NAT64, but enable the switch for unused options. After enabling it, a blank line will appear between the hardware flow control and automatic firmware installation options. In this line, enter the border router address followed by the port number 6638, the same as for Zigbee mode. After this, press the Save button. Now you can start the add-on. Ensure that the auto start and watchdog options are enabled. After this, two new tiles will appear in the integrations menu. Open Thread Border Router and Thread. We don't need to do anything in the first one, but enter the second one. Here, you need to press the configuration button. If everything is done correctly, our router and its network name will be visible in the list of networks. If something else is listed first, like a tab without a network name, press the button to make the router network preferred and delete the empty tab. Check one more thing by pressing the three dots on the right. Ensure that the option to use account data for Android and iOS is enabled. If not, enable it. By pressing the information button, you can see the network name, channel, in this case, 15, PAN ID, and router address. The process of connecting Matter devices involves using a smartphone, as we need to scan a QR code. I also demonstrated this in my video about Matter over Wi-Fi. In this case, there's an additional step to take. In the Home Assistant app connected to your server, go to the App Settings menu. Scroll down to the Troubleshooting section, where there is an option to sync the Thread account. Press it and wait a moment until a confirmation message appears. To connect devices, which I will cover in detail in the next two videos, Bluetooth must be enabled on your phone, as the initial data exchange occurs through it. Start the process from the Devices and Services menu by selecting Add Device. Choose to add a Matter device, then a new device, after which a QR code scanning dialog will open. Another point to note is that on Android smartphones, this dialog is part of the Google Home app. It can add devices to itself as well as to other suitable systems, including Home Assistant, so it should be installed as well. From the perspective of preparing the system for connecting Matter over Thread devices, we have done everything necessary. I will cover the actual connection in my upcoming videos, which will be released very soon. If you are interested in this topic, like this video to help its promotion on YouTube, and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the next episodes. In the description, I will leave all the necessary links to the devices and other reviews I mentioned, my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home questions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.